Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is Khilafat movement. In 1914, when the First World War was started, Turkey joined the alliance of Germany against the British. And later on in the developments, Germany and Turkey lost the war. And at that moment, Turkey was the center of Islamic rule and governance, and the Hejaz and the sacred areas like Mecca and Medina were under the control of Turkish. And Turkey was a big empire that is known as Ottoman Empire, and it was its boundaries were in the Africa, in the Asia, and in Eastern Europe as well. So it was a big empire. ये बड़ी ताकत थी, बड़ी सल्तनत थी, अफ्रीका, एशिया और मशरकी यूरोप तक फैली हुई थी. शिकस्त खा गई. नाउ वी सी द बिगनिंग ऑफ द खिलाफत मूवमेंट. एट द एंड ऑफ द वॉर इट वॉज डिसाइडेड दैट टर्की विल बी ब्रोकन इन टू द parts and different regions will be given the autonomy and the new status, and new countries will be the future of the Turkey. Ke Turkey ko taqseem kar diya jayega, mukhtalif mamalik mein taqseem kar diya jayega, aur Turkey jo hai wo uske hisse bakhre ho jayenge. This was very shocking for the Muslims of the subcontinent. मुसलमान जो थे बरे सगीर के, उनके लिए ये बड़ा ही शॉकिंग न्यूज थी, धचका था, बिकॉज दे वर वेरी मच अटैच्ड स्पिरिचुअली एंड इमोशनली विद द खिलाफत. खिलाफत के इदारे के साथ उनकी जज्बाती वाबस्तगियां भी थी, रूहानी वाबस्तगियां भी थी, तो वो बड़ा धचका था. सो अ मूवमेंट दैट इज कॉल्ड खिलाफत मूवमेंट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड स्टार्टेड इट्स वर्क इन इंडिया. And in 1919, Muslim of the subcontinents gathered in Bombay in July 1919, and they started the Khilafat movement. In November 1919, the first Khilafat conference was held in Delhi, and they announced the steps. Three steps were announced. No participation in victory celebrations, ke Britannia ki victory ki koi hum jashan nahi manayenge. Boycott of the British goods. बरतानवी एशिया क्या बाइकॉट करेंगे. नॉन कोऑपरेशन विद द गवर्नमेंट, और गवर्नमेंट के साथ कोई तआवुन नहीं करेंगे. लेटर ऑन द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स वर रिफाइंड एंड द थ्री ऑब्जेक्टिव्स वर सेट अप ऑफ द खिलाफत मूवमेंट. द फर्स्ट वन वाज टर्किश खिलाफत शुड रिमेन इंटैक्ट. मुसलमानों ने यह मुतालबा किया कि खिलाफत को बरकरार रखा जाए. द हॉली प्लेसेस ऑफ द मुस्लिम्स शुड रिमेन इन द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ द टर्क्स. के जो मकामात मुकदसा हैं उन पे, यानी मक्का और मदीना जो है उन पे तुर्कियों का कंट्रोल ही बाकी रहे. द तुर्किश बाउंड्रीज शुड रिमेन द सेम एज दे वर बिफोर द वार. और तुर्की के हिस्से बखरे ना किए जाएं, बल्कि जंग से पहले जैसी हालत थी तुर्की को वैसे ही कायम रखा जाए. एंड देन फॉर द फॉलो अप अ डेलीगेशन वॉज फॉर्म्ड, एंड दैट डेलीगेशन विजिटेड एंड मेट द वायसराय ऑफ द इंडिया इन द लीडरशिप ऑफ एम ए अंसारी इन जनवरी 1920 के जनवरी में एम ए अंसारी की क्यादत में एक वफद मिला वायसराय ऑफ इंडिया को. एंड द सेकेंड वन अनदर डेलीगेशन वॉज सेंट टू ब्रिटेन, एंड दैट डेलीगेशन मेट द ब्रिटिश प्राइम मिनिस्टर एट दैट टाइम फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ द टर्किश खिलाफत. बट द डिमांड्स वर रिजेक्टेड. ये जो ऑटोमन एम्पायर थी या खिलाफत तुर्किया थी, इसके तहफ़ के लिए ये दोनों वफूद मिले, लेकिन ना तो वायसराय ने कोई हौसला अफजाई की इसकी, और बरतानवी वज़ीर आज़म ने भी इनकार कर दिया. उसने कहा फातेह की शरायत होती है, मफतू की कोई शरायत नहीं होती. नाउ द डेलीगेशन केम बैक and they started the policy of the agitation and the protest, and different activities were performed by the Muslim League, and later on the Congress also started cooperating with Muslims in the Khilafat movement. The first step was financial and the medical aid to the Turkey. Musliman jab mayus ho gaye to unhone Turkey ke liye khud se unko imdad bhejna shuru kar di. Chande ikatthe kiye gaye, donations doctors ki surat mein, nurses ki surat mein aur medical aid ki surat mein bahut sari supplies Turkey ko ki gayi aur yahi wajah hai ke Turkey aaj tak बरेसगीर के लोगों की और खास तौर पे पाकिस्तान के लोगों की कदर करता है क्योंकि मुसलमानों ने उस वक्त भी चंदे भेजे थे और दुनिया के चंद एक ममालिक में तुर्की है जहां पाकिस्तानियों को इज्जत की निगाह से देखा जाता है. लेटर ऑन इन मई 1920 द नॉन कोऑपरेटिव मूवमेंट वाज स्टार्टेड एंड इन दिसंबर 1920 इन द नागपुर सेशन विद द कोलैबोरेशन ऑफ द कांग्रेस मुस्लिम्स डिसाइडेड that surrender the titles awarded by the government ke wo government ki taraf se jo khitabat hain unko wapas kar denge. The educational institutions and the courts of the British government were boycotted. Adalaton ka boycott kar diya gaya, angrezi talimi idaron ka boycott kar diya gaya. The lawyers quit their profession. Iske follow up mein jo wukla hain wo apna profession chhod denge. Resignations were given in the civil administration, police and military jobs. جو انتظامیہ کے شعبے تھے پولیس کے ملٹری کے اور سیول وہاں سے استعفے دے دیے جائیں. ریفیوژل ٹو پے ٹیکسز اور ٹیکس نہ دیے جائیں یعنی جس کو سیول ڈس اوبیڈینس کہتے ہیں سیول نافرمانی یہ شروع کر دی گئی. دیز پروٹیسٹ ور سپریڈ آل اوور دا انڈین سب کانٹیننٹ. لارج پروسیشنز ور آلسو ارینجڈ. مسلم والنٹیئرز پریزنٹڈ دا اریسٹ بفور دا پولیس. لوگوں نے گرفتاریاں بھی دیں, جیلیں بھی بھریں, جیل بھرو تحریک بھی چلی اور یہ سارے شہروں میں یہ مظاہرے پھیل گئے اور کانگریس نے مسلم لیگ کا ساتھ دیا. اونلی دا محمد علی جناح واز دا پرسنالٹی ہو ریفیوزڈ ٹو ٹیک پارٹ ان دس سول ڈس اوبیڈینس موومنٹ. صرف محمد علی جناح تھے جنہوں نے اس سول نافرمانی کی تحریک میں حصہ نہیں لیا. ہی تھاٹ اینڈ ہی ایکسپریسڈ ہز ویوز دیٹ ایکسٹرا کانسٹیٹیوشنل اسٹیپس شوڈ ناٹ بی ٹیکن بائی اینی کمیونٹی اینڈ اسپیشلی بائی مسلمس کہ کوئی غیر آئینی اقدام نہیں کرنا چاہیے مسلمانوں کو احتجاج میں, کسی کو بھی نہیں کرنا چاہیے اور خاص طور پہ مسلمانوں کو بھی نہیں کرنا چاہیے. مسلم جرنلزم, you can see the Zimmedar newspaper of Maulana Zafar Ali Khan, the Al Hilal of Maulana Azad and Maulana Azad's newspaper Al Hilal and the Azad, Comrade and the Hamdard of Maulana Muhammad Ali Johar. These all were the newspapers who supported the cause of سول ڈس اوبیڈینس اینڈ خلافت موومنٹ. یہ سارے اخبارات نے سپورٹ کیا خلافت موومنٹ کو, اس کے کاز کو. وی آلسو کین سی دا رول آف دا گاندھی. فیمس ہندو لیڈرس ایٹ دیٹ موومنٹ ور موہن داس گاندھی اینڈ موتی لال نہرو. دے پارٹیسپیٹڈ ان دا موومنٹ, دے سپورٹڈ دا مسلمس. آن دا ون ہینڈ دے ٹرائیڈ ٹو ٹیک دا گڈ وشیز of the Muslims for their support and on the other hand they succeeded to put the pressure on the British administration. دو فائدے اٹھائے نہرو نے اور گاندھی نے, ایک طرف تو مسلمانوں کی ہمدردیاں سمیٹی اور دوسری طرف برٹش گورنمنٹ پہ بھی پریشر پڑا کہ وہ جو ہے انڈینز کے مطالبات کو تسلیم کریں. لیٹر آن گاندھی پروپوزڈ فار دا مسلمس ٹو اسٹیپ فارورڈ in the protest and also quit the jobs and come to the streets against the government. Log bahar niklein, jobs ko chhodein, giraftariyan dein aur yun ye tehreek jo hai mazid tez ho gayi. An other significant event was the hijrat movement in 1920. Indian subcontinent was declared as a Darul Harb by the Muslims, especially by the Maulana Azad. Indian subcontinent ko Darul Harb qarar de diya. Iska matlab ye hai ki yahan gair islami government hai, yahan se migrate kar jaye and they proposed to migrate to the Afghanistan and the propaganda was that the emperor of the Afghanistan, the Shah of the Afghanistan will welcome the Muslims. The Muslims were started migration to the Afghanistan مسلمانوں نے ہجرت شروع کر دی افغانستان کی طرف کہ شاہ افغانستان ان کا جو ہے وہ استقبال کریں گے. بٹ وین دے ریچڈ افغانستان شاہ اینڈ دا افغان گورنمنٹ اینڈ ایڈمنسٹریشن ریفیوزڈ ٹو ایکسیپٹ دا مسلمز اینڈ دا مسلمز ہیڈ ٹو ریٹرن بیک ٹو دا انڈیا. مسلمانوں کو قبول نہ کیا گیا, مسلمان واپس آئے. Where they sailed their property, left their jobs, and now when they came back, they faced the poverty, they faced the helplessness, and they faced the shortage of food, and humiliated by the other communities. واپس آئے تو قحط کا سامنا بھی ہوا, بھوک کا سامنا بھی ہوا, مسائل کی کمی بھی تھی, جو جائیدادیں اونے پونے داموں بیچی تھی اب وہ مہنگے داموں میں واپس نہیں مل رہی تھی. And we can say that Hijrat movement was unsuccessful and it was a great loss economically, socially, politically for the Muslims. Then another event was mutiny of Mopla, 1921. Mopla was a community and it was they were settled near Calicut in the area of the Malabar, that was a coast of the India. Malabar sahil ke kareeb Calicut ke ilake mein ye log settle the. Moplas participated in the Khilafat movement. They protested, they strongly protested against the British government. British government opened the fire and almost 400 Moplas were martyred. Bada shadeed ehtijaj kiya, 400 Mopla mare bhi gaye, shaheed ho gaye. And Moplas got excited and they flared up, mushtail ho gaye. They came across the streets, they attacked on the British administration, some of the British were killed. Unhone British government ke uhdedaron pe hamle bhi kiye, kuch log mare bhi gaye. And later on, the British government started action with more power against them. And the thousands of the Moplas were martyred. Hazaron Mopla shaheed hue. And this was a very dangerous and a drastic event. Bahut khatarnak tha ye waqia. Aur musalmanon ko isme bada nuksan hua. Jano ke lihaz se bhi aur mali lihaz se bhi. The Hindus the role was very negative in this Mopla movement. They started to support the British government and Hindu community, and Moplas were in front of each other. Dono ek dusre ke samne aa gaye kyunki Hinduon ne mukhbariyan shuru kar di thi aur British government ko support karna shuru kar diya tha, aur Hinduon ko bhi nuksan hua, Musalmanon ko bhi iska nuksan hua. Then another incident of chura chori in 1922, when the civil disobedience movement and non-cooperative movement was started. The Gandhi was leading this. All the Muslim leadership was behind the bars in the jails. Musalmanon ki qiyadat to giriftar ho chuki thi. Gandhi is movement ko ab lead kar rahe the. Musalmanon ki dusre darje ki qiyadat samne thi. An incident took place on 5th of the February 1922 in the village of Chura Chori, where the police administration and the protesters were face to face and they were in front of each other. Aamna saamna hua, ek dusre ke saamne the. The protesters chased the policemen. Policemen gathered in the thana of Chura Chori. That was a police station. To wo thana jo tha, police station, uske andar wo jama hue. They locked themselves, but the Muslim protesters set a fire to that police station. Musalmanon ne us thane ko aag lagai, police station ko, aur 22 policemen were killed. To 22 jo police wale the wo mare gaye. And the Gandhi decided to quit that movement of civil disobedience. Gandhi ne kaha ji, now the element of torture and the lawlessness arised. اب تشدد آ گیا ہے, قانون کی خلاف ورزی آ گئی ہے, تو میں یہ مومنٹ ختم کر رہا ہوں. دس واز اے ویری کریٹیکل مومنٹ. اینڈ لیٹر آن ان ٹرکی اٹ سیلف دا خلافت was abolished. First, the Grand Turkish National Congress abolished the Ottoman Sultanate due to the defeat in the war. Pehle unhone Sultan Wahiduddin jo the unko mazool kiya Grand National Assembly ne Turkey ne ki Turkey shikast kha gaya hai. And Abdul Majid Afandi became the new caliph. And later on the 3rd March 1924, Mustafa Kemal Ataturk presented a bill in the parliament and they decided to secularize the state and also the abolition of the Khilafat. So, ye 3 March jo tha 1924 ye wo mauka tha jab Mustafa Kemal ki qiyadat mein Turkey ke andar usko secular mulk qarar de diya gaya aur Khilafat ka idara khatam kar diya gaya. Turks tried a lot to maintain the Khilafat, but that was not happened. Aur yun Khilafat ka idara khatam kar diya gaya, aur that was a moment of resentment for the Indian Muslims. Aur India ke Muslimano ke liye ye ek aisa mauka tha ki unhe samajh nahi aa rahi thi ab kya karenge, jo Turki ne khud hi isko Khilafat ko khatam kar diya gaya. If we critically see the achievements of the Khilafat movement, we can see it was semi-successful. Makkah and Medina remained under Muslim control and the allied armies did not step in that sacred area. Makkah and Medina mein itihadiya fauj na dakhil hui pressure ki wajah se. Second one, Turkey remained as a country intact. Agarche Turkey se bahut se mumalik ko alaida kar diya gaya, lekin Turkey ka apna jo hai wo wujood barqarar raha. Muslims felt confident and political awareness was aroused among the Indian subcontinent Muslims. Muslimano mein ek aitmad aaya, unme siyasi bedari aayi, and they thought that Qaid-e Azam was right. Ke Qaid-e Azam jo the wo durust the, extra constitutional measures jo hain wo kisi bhi tehreek ki kamyabi ke liye zaruri nahi hote. And this movement was a critical moment as the decline of the religious leadership in the Indian subcontinent. Ye yahan pe mazhabi qiyadat ke zawal ka waqt tha, and this was the starting point of the rise of Qaid-e Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Yahan se Qaid-e Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah ke nuqta-e uruj ka aagaaz tha, aur logon ne unki baat gaur se sunna shuru kar di. The Muslims of the India ultimately started their own struggle to get their constitutional and political rights. Congress ne jo hamare saath kiya and uruj pe chhod di tehreek, to Muslimano ne ye socha ke ab unhe apne aini aur siyasi huquq ke liye indigenous movement shuru karna hogi, aur they got prominent success in future in political and constitutional fields, and ultimately it was resulted on the formation of Pakistan. Congress se taawun khatam kiya apne siyasi aini huquq ki jidd shuru ki, aur uske baad ultimately later on jo waqiat hue uske baad phir Pakistan hasil kiya gaya. Thank you so much.